Pika Kirby, Pika Kirby.
Oomph has a name for this match.
Yeah, he does.
So this is probably going to be pretty common. Probably going to be seeing a lot of Pika Kirby.
Yeah. That's a pretty standard teams lineup. It's a pretty safe teams lineup when you don't know who you're going to be encountering in bracket. And
yeah.
A lot of people will opt for something like that, at least in the first game, to secure their lead.
Right. Kirby's an outstanding teams player. He loses the Pika matchup, but he's able to counteract it by having the almighty down air. Now, that down air is so much more effective in teams than it is in singles, and it's effective in singles.
Right.
But Kirby's a closer. Pikachu's a combo, or Kirby's a closer. That's the way I see it. And can also get Gimps.
So let's see, Rusty and Mustard Tiger. I'm not familiar with their tags, but looks like 4-5 and 4-4.
Yeah.
So they're keeping up.
I mean, I'm not familiar really with any of these people.
I definitely know MHJ and Moonshoes from...
I mean, I know that they're multiple players, right?
Right. And I've seen their tags. Yeah, I guess they must play...
I don't
play
know them beyond where they're from.
Like Xanadu probably is where you've seen the tag. But... four across the board, looking pretty even for a Pika Kirby, Pika Kirby.
Yeah, believe it or not, this is often considered a relatively even matchup. Kind of a lack of teamwork here. It kind of just seems like an all-out brawl.
Yeah.
Good thunder by Pikachu, though. That's a good thing about... So, Kirby's up tilt, obviously outstanding at low percentages. At high percentages, it hits them really high, and you normally can't follow up. But if you have a Pikachu on your team, they can follow up with a thunder and get the kill. So up tilt is useful for all percentages for the entire game.
That's
a great thing about Kirby and teams.
Have you also seen that in the height of Kirby's cutter... you can use down B with Pikachu, use the thunder, and hit him at the height, and it'll kill him off the top blast zone.
Wait, what? Using the cutter?
Yeah.
You mean
no, grab. No, I'm sorry. Yeah, forward throw.
Yeah, I've seen people do it with forward throw. Yeah, if you space it really, really well, because this game's programmed in an interesting way. It seems like the developers probably just physically moved Kirby and the person he's throwing, actually moved them to the very top of the blast zone.
Right.
And so what Pikachu can do is he can follow up with the thunder, and space it so it hits only the person that Kirby's holding, and it'll immediately kill them off the top as Kirby's throwing him. It's pretty tough to pull off, and it's very easy to kill your teammate.
yeah, it definitely is. It's definitely not safe for, a major tournament, but for friendlies, it's a funny gimmick.
Yeah. Red Kirby, looking very weak.
And it just became...
yeah, very... a kind of a commanding lead now.
Fairly one-sided.
Yeah. Low percents for pretty much both the blue team. Pretty low percents for both the blue team. So yeah, you're seeing it again. Instead of securing the edge guard, you 2v1 the person who's left on stage.
Yeah.
I think it's generally what you want to go for. This is the ideal situation, obviously, though. You get both people off at the side, and then Kirby just stands there drill kicking over and over until they're dead.
Could be an edge guard.
Yeah. Okay, so he went for the... I think he was trying to save him there. A down air would have gotten him out of the throw.
That's a stock on blue Kirby.
Back throw on Kirby is devastating, especially in teams. The back throw, Pikachu's back throw, one of the best in the game. But it's in this matchup, it's really good at killing Kirby, and it's really good at splitting up Kirby if it doesn't kill him.
Right.
And Kirby has a very long recovery.
So that's a victory.
So that's game one to Rusty and Mustard Tiger.
Yeah. We need to change the scoreboard. Yeah. There it is. 1-0 for the tags that we don't recognize. Interesting turn of events. 3, 2, 1.
damage across the board.
Yeah. Saved Blue Kirby out of that back throw. Pikachu had him in the back throw. Blue's playing a much better teams game right now than they did. And at the end of last game as well, they started to be more coordinated.
Coordination is key in teams. You don't want it to be two 1v1s, and you don't want it to be everyone jumping in hitting each other.
Right.
There needs to be a clear structure. Each team member needs to know their role when they're playing. It needs to be obvious who needs to go for what and when. And that's something you can only develop after, you know, playing with someone for long enough. You develop some synergy.
Yeah, you tend to find a lot of times you'll play doubles with a random, you know, decent player, top level player, and you'll find that you're both going for the edge guard, or you're just getting in each other's way, and you end up getting each other killed because of it. So there are a lot of team dynamics that you have to work on over time, or sometimes people just tend to be good matches for each other. I feel like Tacos and Boom, they hit it
Tacos
off.
And Boom, for some, for one reason, they both have an extremely intimate knowledge of the game. They're both very high level players. But, oh, that was a good save by Kirby.
Yeah,
but it didn't end well, unfortunately. But anyway, Tacos and Boom, yeah, both extremely high level players, but seem to coordinate very, very well. Tacos matches well with anyone he plays with, I've noticed.
That's true. Yeah, very good with Senor as well. Senor and Tacos play a very, very good team.
Yeah, Boomfan also extremely good at doubles, obviously.
Yeah.
Just very good at the game.
Yeah, I mean, Boomfan and Jaime.
May 4.
Yeah.
That's what Kirby wants to fish for pretty much the entire set. Anytime he can get a down air kill, gimp, whatever, he needs
That
was a great pass.
You see that?
That was a great, great
That
catch.
Was a forward smash, two grab, and back throw. That was...
I have to think that was intentional because there was no other reason he could have been grabbing.
Right.
The other character was dead. So.
Yeah, that was if that was intentional, that was very impressive.
I don't see any reason to think it wasn't.
Right. He'd been sitting there for a while.
He's
not just going to arbitrarily throw out a grab. That's like highlight reel stuff.
Absolutely.
I thoroughly enjoyed that.
Very interesting down air to down smash. Seemed to work out. Got them both off stage, but there was no...
Turned around and almost looked like he went for a reverse down tilt, but he got punished. Blue Kirby got punished for missing what could have been an easy edge guard.
Okay, so Pikachu came in a little early with that up air there. I think he was 1% from death.
Yeah, that was very close.
Off the side platform.
Oh. Blue Pikachu.
Either 1 or 9.
Blue Pikachu took damage from Kirby, but he recovered only to lose his stock in the end. So 1-2 and 3-2. It's in favor of MHJ and Moonshoes this time.
Actually, much more like a really big improvement in this game. If they can hold the lead.
Yeah.
Having a. Two stock to a three stock.
That's going to be a stock on Pikachu. That was a really good down air. He went in
full
force.
Again, Kirby's down air is so commanding in teams.
Yeah.
The up tilt in the down air. Oh, a little early. If he had gone out after and gone a little bit higher, Pikachu was waiting for it too.
Yeah.
If he had gone out higher and later, he could have caught the down air after the throw and it would have been game. And again, Pikachu got a grab, but he prematurely followed up. Pretty good dash. Oh, great back air.
You know, MHA and Moonshoes are looking good for teams right now, too. It looks like, you know, the first match, both teams did a lot of warming up, and we're seeing a lot more synchronized combos and stuff. So that's pretty cool.
Yeah, that was a... It's looking like a good set. See, when Kirby lands an up tilt like that, the red Kirby landed an up tilt. Blue Kirby was completely free, and he didn't protect his ally from the follow-up.
Right.
It's such an obvious thing, and you need to be looking for it.
That was good DI. It looked like red Pikachu got DI to save him from the down air.
It seems like when it comes to edge guards, at least I think, it seems like each team are kind of doing a rough job of defining roles. So I think,
yeah, exactly.
I think for Pikachu's recovery, if he's close enough to the stage where he can go high, one player needs to cover top platform and one player needs to cover edge and ledge. Pikachu can go to either one, but if you've got someone at both places, there's no reason that he should be able to recover.
Yeah, exactly. And like right here,
that was a really good nair.
But Blue Kirby was on the other side of the stage.
That was team kill. Unfortunate team kill by Red Kirby. Red Kirby not really feeling the team dynamic the same way.
Yeah, so, you know, I think exactly what that is Red Kirby is an aggressive player, which is fine, which is completely fine. What tends to be the case is that the aggressive player dominates in front while the other
tries to control the match.
Yeah, while the other teammate offers support when they need help.
That's an okay way to play the game. But even if you're playing lead aggressor, it's important to see when you have a follow up coming. You can't if your allies get that could have been a reverse cutter. That was a really good back air by or Pikachu.
Could have gotten it on
even
both.
Even if
of
it
them.
Got Red Kirby killed, I think Red Kirby was dead anyway. That was a good trade.
So did you see both red players jumping out to edgeguard at the same time? They actually both got punished for it.
It's very risky. If you don't know who should be going for the edge guards, you really risk getting both of you killed if you mess it up. You risk killing each other. You risk getting caught in the edge guard. I personally think it makes it more difficult to get the edge guard in the first place.
Yeah, exactly.
With two people out there.
Especially because you got to watch out for your ally. I mean, you know, you're gonna lose an edge guard opportunity because it's gonna kill your ally, and then it's not worth it anymore. So.
Right.
But you could also be in a situation where you think that they're gonna go for the edge guard, and then they think you're gonna go for the edge guard, and then no one does the edge guarding. So they just recover or, you know, turn it on you.
Again, just something you need to learn with overtime, team dynamics.
Yeah.
Maybe discuss before the set and try to keep in mind who's going for the edge guards if you're both free.
Yeah.
Whether you'll more often go high or low if both is an option for the recoverer. Kind of a random rock there by Kirby, but Pikachu jumps in. Trying to defend his partner. Punish. So Kirby out, but Pika kind of stock tanking. Both red team in a pretty rough spot right now.
Yeah. I mean, if Pikachu had lost that stock, it would have evened things out, but.
Oh,
Kirby. Kirby going kind of low.
Yeah, Kirby was able to sweet spot the ledge. He messed that up a little bit earlier when he was trying to space it. But looks like a pretty strongly in Red's favor right now. The 2v1 is exactly what you want.
Yeah, so this would put it at 1-2.
The triple?
That's it. So 2-1. Overall, these teams were fun to watch. And
Moonshoes, right?